Those Eorzeans certainly are a stubborn bunch. Though I suppose you knew that already. My plan to redirect the ether from Cartano came to a rather less than satisfactory conclusion. It was, in many respects, an abject failure. Which does, of course, raise the question of where we are going to procure the requisite amount. The obvious solution would be to draw on resources a little closer to home, though that would require our dreamer to dream a trifle more deeply.
So be it. The dreamer will not complain.
Then let us begin the preparations at once. With the gateway of the gods complete, all that remains is to gather the necessary ether, and our prize shall be within reach. The time has come to fulfill your heart's desire, my desire! To relieve those wretched creatures of their meaningless existence!
While I await you, I shall drink a sea of souls and gorge myself upon the darkened moon. Then you shall come to me, all roiling rage and rancor. And the stars shall bear witness to our final contest.
As I thought, the ethereal currents have been disturbed here too.
It was the same in Thanalan. Make that every location we surveyed.
And the strength of each current has diminished dramatically, far more than could be attributed to a natural occurrence.
What tidings bringest thou from Dravania?
We took a number of readings, and noticed that the closer we were to the tower, the lower the etheric density became. In short,
the towers are drawing upon the land's ether, which would explain how they were able to carry out the summonings.
Our allies must be informed of this. We should return to the Rising Stones and have Tataru relay our findings to them.
Hear me. Darkness comes. And with it, the end. The fate of the star is in your hands.
Everything all right back there?
Thank you.